And we can have you all to take your seats. We're about to get started in about 10 to 12 minutes. Ladies and gentlemen, if we can have you take your seats, we'll be getting started in about 10 to 12 minutes. Thank you so much for your patience.
Thank you. move over here, okay? So just cut away to a crowd shot. Recording that? Good thinking.
Y'all look small. All right, Nafia. How y'all doing?
Well, she tapped.
Y'all look good.
So nice. You're my water when I'm stuck in the desert. You're the talent all I take when my head hurts. You're the sunshine of my life. I just wanna see how beautiful you are. You know that I see it. I know you're a star. Where you go, I follow.
If life is a movie, then you're the best part.
Dearly beloved, brothers and sisters, family and friends, we have joined together today to witness Shane and Synetra to be joined in holy matrimony. For the Bible declares that marriage is a permanent relationship between one man and one woman, freely and totally committed to each other as companions for life. The Lord declared that man shall leave his father and mother and unite with a wife in the building of a home, and the two shall become one flesh. Who is it that gives this bride to be married? Shane and Synetra will face each other now, and y'all don't have to hold hands right now. We're just gonna talk.
I want to hold hands.
The home is built upon love. Paul declared in 1 Corinthians chapter 13, love is patient, love is kind, love is not jealous nor boastful. It is not arrogant or rude. Love does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrong, but rejoices in the right. Love bears all things. Love never ends. Love believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. Marriage is a companionship that involves mutual commitment. Some may say 50-50, 60-30, 60-40, 70-30, but it takes 100-100. You're exhorted to dedicate your home to your Creator. Take His Word, the Bible, as your guide. Give loyal devotion to His church. And uniting with mutual strength in these two most important institutions such as the home and the church. Let us pray. All wise and eternal God, we thank you now for this day. Lord, we thank you for this couple. Thank you for all the families, all the friends that who have joined to witness this ceremony. Lord, we pray, oh God, as they come together, Lord, we pray that you will be the glue, oh God, that will hold them together, help them to have understanding for one another. Help them, oh God, while they're on the mountaintop, but oh Lord, when they experience valleys in life, Lord, we pray that you'll continue to be there with them. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. All right. Shane.
That's me.
Will you take Synetra to be your wife? Will you commit your happiness to her self-fulfillment as a person, to her usefulness in God's kingdom? And do you promise to love, to honor, to trust, and serve her in sickness and in health, in adversity and prosperity, as long as you both shall live?
I do. I will. All else. Yes.
Synetra, will you take Shane to be your husband? Will you commit yourself in happiness and his self-fulfillment as a person and to his usefulness in God's kingdom? And do you promise to love, to honor, to trust, and serve him in sickness and in health, in adversity and prosperity, and to be true and loyal to him so long as you both shall live? Greens, please. Before we place the rings, we understand that the wedding ring is symbolic of marriage in two ways. The purity of gold symbolizes the purity of love that you have for each other. The unending circle, it symbolizes the unending vows that you're taking. And these vows can only be honorably broken in the sight of God by death. So as you receive these, we pray that you'll have the purity that the gold symbolizes, but also the unending love for each other that the unending circle symbolizes. Shane, if you'll take her ring finger and repeat after me. Synetra.
Synetra.
You want to say boo?
Baby.
Baby. With this ring.
With this ring.
I pledge my life and love to you.
I pledge my life and love to you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
The Son.
The Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
We place the ring on. I got a rock. Synetra, if you'll take this ring finger and repeat after me. Shane.
Shane.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I pledge my love and life to you.
I pledge my love and life to you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
The Son.
The Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
All right. We have a sand. The sand. Let's take care of the sand ceremony here, if you will, just for a moment.
Supposed to. What info? Oh, I forgot this mic. Oh, this ain't gonna be good.
Isaiah pouring the sand just symbolizes all the things that they come as individuals that they bring to the relationship.
Man, God, dang.
They're not only her situations or his situation, but they are their situations now. You can only imagine how hard it would be or how challenging it would be to separate all those particles of sand after being poured together. That's how you want to make it that much challenging to be pulled apart from each other. Okay, both of you all repeat after me, and if you all can't hear them, just kind of raise your hand and I'll do it again. Entreat me not to leave you.
Entreat me not to leave you.
Oh, two of you all. One and two.
I'm so mesmerized.
That's all right.
Let's start over. My bad.
Jesus Christ. Entreat me not to leave you.
Entreat me not to leave you.
Or to return from following you.
Or to return from following you.
For where you go.
For where you go.
I will go.
I will go.
For where you live.
For where you live.
I will live.
I will live.
Your people.
Your people.
Shall be my people.
Shall be my people.
And my people shall be your people.
And my people shall be your people.
Your God shall be my God.
Shall be my God.
My brothers and sisters, since this couple have made these commitments before God and this assembly of witness by the authority of God and the laws of this state, I declare Shane and Synetra husband and wife. Woo! Shane and Synetra, you are no longer two independent persons, but one. What therefore God has joined together, let no man or woman tear it apart.
Well,
you may now get some sugar. Just in case Shane didn't know, the Bible declares that he who finds a wife
finds a good thing.
Finds a good thing.
And I did.
And he finds favor with the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. and Mrs. Shane Boyd.
Thank you. think that's
my favorite. Hot dog.